Does music help with our daily activities? By Atuonga. Abstract. Music is something we listen to every day, whether that be the music in an elevator or the music on the radio. We've all listened to it. Most people listen to music while doing something productive, like studying or exercising. But how effective is it? How do you know what types of music are good for what you want to do? And does music make you any better at what you're doing? Well, in this study, I hope to get a better understanding of how music affects our lives. In this study, I will be doing some tests with different types of music to determine what types of music are better for certain tasks. These three tasks will focus on exercising, typing, and memory/puzzle solving. I'll also look at professionals' opinions on this topic to truly understand how listening to music works. Results/variables. Results. I conclude that for studying, it is better to listen to calm music. For exercising, you should listen to fast-paced music, but not too fast-paced, or else you'll burn yourself out. For puzzle solving, anything except normal music works. This study shows the type of music we listen to has an effect on the task we're performing. Listening to the right music will maximize your efficiency while working. The variables that are present in this project are: the independent variable is the type and tempo of the music, also the age of the subjects. The dependent variable is productivity in the chosen activity. The control variables are the three same music tracks and the three same activities. Research 1. I'll be comparing my findings with other research done by the topic. First, from acefitness.org, I can learn about the effects of music on exercise. I want to link above, quote, "Music is like a legal drug for athletes," says Kostas Kara Georges, PhD from London Brunel University School of Sport and Education, one of the world's leading authorities on music and exercise. It can reduce the perception of effort significantly and increase endurance by as much as 15%. What I've learned from this debate is that the faster the music is, the more efficient the exercise is. Our brains follow the tempo and help us work faster and more efficiently. However, this comes at a cost. The faster we go, the faster our heart beats, and so the key isn't to pick fast-paced music. It's to pick music that is fast enough that we improve in our exercise, but not too fast that we work our bodies too hard. Research 2. Next, from funtersin.org, I can learn about the effects of music on learning. From the link above, Husen et al. 2002 states that besides these two mediation effects, mood and around and arousal meditating, the influence of background music on learning, and in contrast to the Mozart effect, music does not directly influence learning. What I've learned from this page is that while fast-paced music works well for exercise, slow-paced music is better for studying, but not because it improves focus. Slow-paced music improves our mood, which in turn improves our focus. Based on this, we can also deduce the fact that fast-paced music makes us more exciting and in turn removes focus. While blind focus might be good in exercising, it's not good in studying. Research 3. Next, we have www.theguardian.com, where I can learn about the effects of music on productivity. From the link above, quote, Kirsten Nelson, a music therapist at the University of Iowa Stead Family Children Hospital, suggests tracks like Here Comes the Sun by the Beatles and Ooh Child by the Five Stair Steps at Place to Start. If you're feeling really down in the morning, then find something peaceful to start with. From there, you can get into a more motivating song to achieve the state you want. What I've learned from this page is that, unlike studying, faster music has a peak at where it affects work. And in my opinion, it's actually higher than studying, because working typically requires you to do the same thing multiple times in a row and doesn't involve any complex thoughts. Research 4. Finally, we have WebMD.com, where I can learn about the effects of music on productivity. From the link above, quote, "Yes, there is data that can help people falling asleep," says Michael Bruce, PhD, a boy of sleep expert and author of The Sleep Doctor's Diapen, Simple Rules for Losing Weight While You Sleep. But the kind of music you pick makes a difference. Music that is relatively slow may help your body hit its internal snooze button. If you play Guns N' Roses, chances are low that it will put you to sleep, says Bruce. From this site, I've learned that when it comes to sleep, the only thing that matters is that the song's too sad, or is that the song isn't too sad or too exciting. As long as it doesn't emit strong emotions, it's fine. You should also not wear earbuds, because those can be uncomfortable and make you focus too much on certain things about the song. In conclusion, I've learned about how music affects multiple types of activities now, and I'll take that knowledge to conduct a study. This graph is from acefitness.org and shows different types of music being played while the subjects are exercising. This graph is from frontersin.org and shows working memory capacity with and without music. This graph shows studying capacity and performance while listening to music. Procedure. Now that I have graphs to compare to, I will conduct a study with three subjects, 1 12 years old, 1 20 years old, and 1 50 years old. I will perform three tests with three types of music. Very calm music, neutral music, and very fast music. The first test will be exercising, the second test will be typing, the third test will be a blind Tower of Annoy test where the subjects have to remember the combination they did to finish the problem. The 12-year-old will not be participating in the third test because he already knows the solution. I'll be charting down the performance and making graphs based on the music that we'll be playing. Graph 4. From this graph, I can see that generally the faster the music is, the more exercise is done. However, for the 12-year-old, they did worse and fast than they did in neutral. Perhaps different ages have different burnout times. From this graph, I can see that looser, calmer music works much better for typing. This graph further proves that calm music helps more with typing and you can reduce the amount of errors you make. This graph shows that neutral music is the worst for puzzle solving. As Kirsten Nelson says, it doesn't emit any strong emotion, so you don't feel calm and collected, and you don't feel pumped to solve it. Conclusion. In conclusion, music helps us work harder, even if we're not concentrated. For exercise, we should have very fast-paced music, but not too fast, as we might push ourselves too hard. For typing, calm music is perfect. It helps us stay collected and focused. For puzzle solving, anything works. As long as it's not too normal for sleeping, we just need a normal and calming song. Take these into consideration and try to think about what music you're listening to while doing various activities as it makes a difference. Future directions. More research is needed to truly discover the true potential of music. Maybe one day we'll be able to use music to boost our productivity and help us work harder to become a better person. Music might affect other activities differently. Maybe you can simulate and make certain types of music that are suited to help with certain activities like exercise. Only time will tell. We're excited. Pace. Fitness.org, frontersin.org, theguardian.com, webmd.com.